Dear children, with a warm welcome to our class. Today I would like to start your first lesson in English. In our routine life, we get hundreds of advices from many people. Amma, appa, ajja, ajji, relatives, teachers, friends, all these people advise us. But we adopt very few advices among them. Then we remember very few advices throughout our life, and very few advices change the very way of living of our life. In our today's lesson, we are going to study about one such advice under the title, The Best Advice I Ever Had. Okay, the title of the lesson is The Best Advice I Ever Had, and this was written by Mrs. Vijayalakshmi Pandit. Mrs. Vijayalakshmi Pandit was the sister of our first Prime Minister Jawaharlal Nehru, and she wrote this article for a monthly magazine. It is an international level monthly magazine called Reader's Digest when she was serving as the High Commissioner for India in the United Kingdom. Children, in your social science, you have studied how always the weaker section of the society was exploited by the superior section of the society. You have studied about gender discrimination, practice of untouchability, practice of slavery, etc., etc., etc. If we talk about gender discrimination, we know that throughout the pages of history, women were always taught that their priority is to care their family and to take care of their children. Nobody understood that women also had got their own individual existence. Okay, everybody forgot that women also had got their own dreams and wishes. Still, there are many women throughout the world who have crossed all these limits and made their own contribution to the society and achieved a lot. Mrs. Vijayalakshmi Pandit was also one of such women. Let us know something about Mrs. Vijayalakshmi Pandit first. So, Mrs. Vijayalakshmi Pandit was born in the year 1900. Okay. So, she was born in the year 1900 and she died in the year 1990. Then, she took an active participation in the freedom movement of India. She was imprisoned 3 times. During the time of Quit India movement also she was imprisoned. Then after independence, she served as a diplomat politician. She held very high national and international positions. She served as an Indian ambassador to Soviet Union, United Kingdom, United States of America, Spain, Mexico, Ireland, etc. Even she served as the High Commissioner for India in United Kingdom. It is a matter of pride for Indians that the first women president of UN General Assembly was from India, and she was none other than our Vijayalakshmi Pandit. So, she was the first women president of UN General Assembly. Taking into consideration her contribution to the freedom movement of India, our former president Ramaswamy Venkatraman has called her the luminous strand in the tapestry of Indian freedom struggle. Dear children, language classes always not only aim at developing language skills among the children, they aim at emotional development of the children. They want the children to know about the culture and heritage of their nation and the world. They want to inculcate moral values among the children, and they want to see the children mature. After reading this lesson, we will understand how to respect our mother. We will understand our mother is not only our mother, she too has got an individual existence. She too has got her own dreams to fulfill. And she too has to achieve something in her life. And the advice about which we are studying, no, in this lesson, so that advice motivates us for self-retrospection. Here, self-retrospection means, children, atmavalokana. This advice makes us to think, whatever we are doing, whether it is right or wrong. If it is wrong, how to improve ourselves? So, totally, this is a nice lesson. Let us read and understand this lesson. First, in the beginning of the lesson, they have given you an activity. I will leave this activity as a homework for you. They have given the pictures of six ladies here, I think you can see. And you have to write, identify them, and you have to write their names there in the space given below. Then their achievement is explained here in column 1, column A. In front of that particular achievement, you have to write which among these ladies made that achievement. You have to write their names. So, complete it in your home today. Now, coming to the lesson. I will have the chart of difficult words. Yes, here I have the chart of difficult words. Now, I will go through the lesson. Children, keep your textbook open. Have a pencil in your hand. So, underline the difficult words and meanings there. Now, paragraph 1. The best advice I ever had came from one of the greatest souls the world has ever known, Mahatma Gandhi. On a sunny afternoon, a decade ago, most people pass through a period of anguish when their belief in humanity is at a low ebb. I was in such a period. My husband had recently died. My deep sorrow over his loss was followed by the humiliating realization that, in the eyes of Indian law, I had no individual existence. Along with other Indian women, I had participated for years with men in the national struggle for freedom, working and suffering side by side with them until it had finally been achieved. Yet, in law, we women were still recognized only through our relationship to men. Now, as a widow, without a son, I was not entitled to any share of the family property, nor were my two daughters. I resented this galling position. I was bitter towards those members of my family who supported this antiquated law. Now, you underline these words. In paragraph number 1, you underline decade, okay, decade. Then in paragraph number 2, underline anguish and humiliating. In paragraph 3, you underline resented, galling and antiquated. Okay, so when you heard me reading these three paragraphs, you understood that the best advice of Mrs. Vijayalakshmi Pandit's life, she got from one of the greatest souls of the world, that is Mahatma Gandhiji. Okay, then she says that, let us see, she says that almost all the people, when they go through difficult position, difficult situation in their life, they lose faith in the humanity itself. She says that most people pass through a period of anguish when their belief in humanity is at a low ebb. Here, anguish means, children, anguish means severe mental or physical pain. So, most of the people go through a period of anguish when they lose faith in humanity. So, whenever we come across with a difficult situation, we feel that we are all alone and nobody is there to help us. We lose our faith in our family members. We lose our faith in our relatives and our friends. So, Vijayalakshmi Pandit was also in such a position. She had lost her husband. Okay. She had lost her husband, and after the death of her husband, she had to realize that in the eyes of Indian law, she had not got individual existence. It was a humiliating realization for her. What is the meaning of humiliating, children? Here, humiliating means embarrassing. Okay, embarrassing situation for her, that in the eyes of Indian law, she had not got individual existence. Why did she feel like that? See, she had taken active participation in the Indian freedom struggle. With other Indian women, for years, she sacrificed her personal life, and until independence was achieved for India, she suffered and she made an active participation in the freedom movement. Then after her death, what happened? After her husband's death, what happened? She did not get a share in the family property. Okay. She had not got a son. As a widow, without a son, with two daughters, she herself and her daughters did not get any share in the family property. That was humiliating for her. That was embarrassing for her. Already she is in sorrow because she had lost her husband. Okay. Then she understood that her motherland, which she loved the most, did not recognize her individual existence. The law of her motherland did not give her a share in the family property. Here, the matter is not about sharing the family property. The matter is about the existence of the individual existence of herself. She was considered, she was recognized through her relationship to men. That was the fact which humiliated, that was the fact which pained Vijayalakshmi Pandit very much. Okay. She resented that galling position. She resented that galling position. Resented means she felt very bitter about that galling position. So, resent means, children, to feel bitter about. She felt very sad about that. And galling means annoying or irritating. She felt resented or she felt very bitter about that irritating situation. She felt very sad. She had not got an individual existence in the eyes of her motherland's law, and her family members who she loved for such a long period, they too had supported that antiquated law. For that, she was very much unhappy. So, let us see what happens later. So, let us go through the next paragraph. At this time, I went to pay my respects to Gandhiji and say goodbye before leaving to America to take part in a conference. After our talk, he asked, "Have you made your peace with your relatives?" I was amazed that he would take sides against me. "I have not quarreled with anyone," I replied, "but I refuse to have anything to do with those who take advantage of an outworn law to create a difficult and humiliating situation for me." Okay, so Vijayalakshmi Pandit respected Gandhiji very much. She got an opportunity to go to United States of America to participate in a conference. Okay, so before going to America, she decided to meet Gandhiji, who she respected very much. She went to Gandhiji. For a few minutes, they spoke on different matters. And then afterwards, Gandhiji asked her, "Have you made peace with your family members? Have you made your peace with your relatives?" he asked. Vijayalakshmi Pandit did not expect this at all. Vijayalakshmi Pandit yen tilkondidlu andre, avulige avu family members mele bejaragittalva. ಅವರು ಆ ಲಾವನ್ನು ಸಪೋರ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರು, ಫ್ಯಾಮಿಲಿ ಪ್ರಾಪರ್ಟಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ತನ್ನ ಶೇರ್ ಕೊಡಲಿಲ್ಲ, ಅವಳಿಗೆ ಫ್ಯಾಮಿಲಿ ಮೆಂಬರ್ಸ್ ಮೇಲೆ ಏನು ದುಃಖ ಇತ್ತಲ್ವಾ, ಅದು ಸರಿಯಾ, ಅವರಿಂದ ಏನು ದೂರ ಹೊರಡೋ ವಿಚಾರದಲ್ಲಿ ಇದ್ದಲ್ವಾ, ಅದು ತಾನು ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇರೋ ಸರಿ, ಅದನ್ನು ಗಾಂಧೀಜಿ ಕೂಡ ಸಪೋರ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ ಅಂತ ಶಿ ಥಾಟ್. ಬಟ್ ವಾಟ್ ಡಿಡ್ ಗಾಂಧೀಜಿ ಡು? ಶಿ ಆಸ್ಕ್ಡ್, ಇನ್ಸ್ಟೆಡ್ ಹಿ ಆಸ್ಕ್ಡ್. ವಾಟ್ ಡಿಡ್ ಹಿ ಆಸ್ಕ್? ಹಿ ಆಸ್ಕ್ಡ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್, "ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಯು ಮೇಡ್ ಪೀಸ್ ವಿತ್ ಯುವರ್ ರಿಲೇಟಿವ್ಸ್?" ಸೊ Vijayalakshmi Pandit did not expect it from Gandhiji. She felt sad for this and she replied, I have never quarreled with anybody. Na yar jothe jagala maadkollilla. I have never quarreled with anybody, but I refuse to have anything with those people who take advantage of an outworn law. ಅವ್ರ ಜೊತೆ ಯಾರು ತನಗೆ ದುಃಖವನ್ನು ಕೊಡುವಂತಹ ಒಂದು ಲಾವನ್ನು ಸಪೋರ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೋ ಅವ್ರ ಜೊತೆ ಯಾವುದೇ ರೀತಿಯ ಸಂಬಂಧ ಇಟ್ಕೊಳ್ಳೋದಕ್ಕೆ ತಾನು ರೆಡಿ ಇಲ್ಲ. ಹೂ ಟೋಲ್ಡ್ ದಿಸ್? ಇಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ಟೋಲ್ಡ್ ಬೈ ವಿಜಯಲಕ್ಷ್ಮಿ ಪಂಡಿತ್. ದೆನ್ ಗಾಂಧೀಜಿ ಕಂಟಿನ್ಯೂಡ್. ಗಾಂಧೀಜಿ ಲುಕ್ಡ್ ಔಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ವಿಂಡೋ ಫಾರ್ ಅ ಮೂಮೆಂಟ್. ದೆನ್ ಹೀ ಟರ್ನ್ ಟು ಮೀ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಸ್ಮೈಲ್ಡ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಸೆಡ್, ಯು ವಿಲ್ ಗೋ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಸೇ ಗುಡ್ ಬೈ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ courtesy and decency demand this. In India, we still attach importance to these things. So for a while, for a minute, Gandhiji kept quiet. Then he was looking out through the window there. Then he turned towards Vijayalakshmi Pandit and he told, no, you have to go to your family members and say bye to them, because courtesy and decency demand this. What is the meaning of courtesy, children? Courtesy means good manners, polite speech. Can you see? Good manners, polite speech, or polite action. So in India, till today, we attach importance for what? This courtesy and decency. That is why you have to go to your family members. You have to meet and say bye to them. Then Vijayalakshmi Pandit told, no, I declare, not even to please you will I go to those who wish to harm me. Okay, Vijayalakshmi Pandit told that, not even to please you, ninugu khushi maadbeku anta kuda nanu avriddalli hogodilla, I will not meet them. Vijayalakshmi Pandit refused. Then Gandhiji continued, no one can harm you except yourself, he said, still smiling. I see enough bitterness in your heart to cause you injury unless you check it. Gandhiji told that no one can harm you except yourself. Ninige ninna horatagi bere yaru kettadanna madlikke sadhya illa. See, this is the best advice which Vijayalakshmi Pandit got from Mahatma Gandhiji. He told that no one can harm you except yourself. Ninna horatagi ninige bere yaru kettadu madlikke sadhya illa. Okay, he continued, I see enough bitterness in your heart. Nin heart alli I can see bitterness about your family members, about your motherland. Unless you come out of that bitterness, unless you sort out that bitterness, unless you check it, stop it, it will cause you more injury. You will be there in pain. So whenever you have quarrel with your loved ones, maybe with your amma, maybe with your friends, what type of a feeling you will have in your heart? You will feel very bitter, no? You cannot enjoy your food. You cannot sleep properly during night. Okay? Because you love them very much. You know that they too love you very much. But still, for some reason, at that time you are unhappy. Until you speak to them, until you clear that misunderstanding, you only will be unhappy, and whatever things you do on those days, you know, they will not be successful. So no one can harm you except yourself. It is you who have to solve the problem there, who have to come out of the misunderstanding there, and who have to keep yourself happy. No one can harm you except yourself. Gandhiji told that unless you check that bitterness in her heart, no? So she could not come out of her pain. That bitterness in her heart would injure her more. So that was told by Gandhiji. Then Vijayalakshmi Pandit kept quiet. Gandhiji continued, I remained silent, and he continued, you are going to a new country because you are unhappy and want to escape. Can you escape from yourself? Will you find happiness outside when there is bitterness in your heart? Think it over. Be a little humble. You have lost a loved one. That is sorrow enough. Must you inflict further injury on yourself because you lack courage to cleanse your own heart? See, Gandhiji told that Vijayalakshmi Pandit, you are going to another country because you want to escape from your family members. You are unhappy and you are not ready to face your family members and you are not ready to live in your motherland. That is why you are going outside. You are going out of the nation. But can you escape from yourself? The pain is there in your heart. The pain is not there in India or not there in America. Where is the pain? The pain is in your heart. Nin heartalli dukkha untu. Can you escape from yourself? If you go to America there, can you escape from yourself? Will the pain in yourself, will it go out? ನಿನಗೆ ನಿನ್ನ ರಿಲೇಟಿವ್ಸ್ ಮೇಲೆ ಮತ್ತೆ ನಿನ್ನ ಮದರ್ ಲ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಮೇಲೆ ಇರುವಂತಹ ದುಃಖ, ಇಫ್ ಯು ಗೋ ಟು ಅಮೆರಿಕಾ ವಿಲ್ ಇಟ್ ಬಿ ಸಾಲಿಡ್? ಹಿ ಆಸ್ಕ್ಡ್. ಆಲ್ರೆಡಿ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ಯುವರ್ ಹಸ್ಬೆಂಡ್, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಸಾರೋ ಇನಫ್. ಸಾಕಷ್ಟು ದುಃಖ ಇದೆ ನಿನಗೆ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ಯುವರ್ ಹಸ್ಬೆಂಡ್, ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ಯುವರ್ ಲವ್ಡ್ ಒನ್. ಮಸ್ಟ್ ಯು ಇನ್ಫ್ಲಿಕ್ಟ್? ಸಿ ಹಿಯರ್, ಮಸ್ಟ್ ಯು ಇನ್ಫ್ಲಿಕ್ಟ್ ಚಿಲ್ಡ್ರನ್? ಇನ್ಫ್ಲಿಕ್ಟ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಟು ಇಂಪೋಸ್, ಟು ಕಾಸ್. ನೀನು ನಿನ್ನ ಮೇಲೆ ಇನ್ನೂ ದುಃಖವನ್ನ ಕೊಟ್ಕೊಳ್ಬೇಕಾ, ನಿನಗೆ ಇನ್ನೂ ದುಃಖವನ್ನ ಕೊಟ್ಕೊಳ್ಬೇಕಾ? ಬೀಯಿಂಗ್ ಅವೇ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಯುವರ್ ರಿಲೇಟಿವ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಯುವರ್ ಮದರ್ ಲ್ಯಾಂಡ್, ಹೂ ಯು ಲವ್ ದ ಮೋಸ್ಟ್. ಸೊ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಯು ಡೋಂಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಕರೇಜ್ ಟು ಕ್ಲೀನ್ ಯುವರ್ ಹಾರ್ಟ್, ವಾಟ್ ಎವರ್ ಬಿಟರ್ನೆಸ್ ಈಸ್ ದೇರ್ ಇನ್ ಯುವರ್ ಹಾರ್ಟ್, ನೋ ಯು ಕೆನಾಟ್ ಕ್ಲೀನ್ ಇಟ್. ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ವೈ ಯು ವಾಂಟ್ ಟು ಗೋ ಟು ಅದರ್ ಕಂಟ್ರಿ. ವಿಲ್ ಯು ಬಿ ಹ್ಯಾಪಿ ದೇ? ಹಿ ಆಸ್ಕ್ಡ್. ದೆನ್ ವಾಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್ಸ್? ಲೆಟ್ ಅಸ್ ಸಿ. So whenever we get advice from the people who we respect very much, no, definitely we start thinking. Do you agree, no, children? So whenever we get advice from our loved ones and respected ones, we start thinking. The same thing happened with Vijayalakshmi Pandit. Let us see. His words would not leave me. They gave me no peace. After some days of severe struggle with myself, I finally telephoned my brother-in-law. I would like to see you and the family, I said before leaving. Okay, so Vijayalakshmi Pandit was not left in peace after her talk to Gandhiji. She started to think, whatever I am doing, is it right or wrong? America ke hogodu tappalla, adre ಅಮೇರಿಕಕ್ಕೆ ಹೋಗೋದ್ರ ಹಿಂದಿನ ರೀಸನ್, ಯಾರದ ಮೇಲೆ ಬೇಜಾರು ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡು ಹೋಗ್ಬಾರ್ದು ಅಮೇರಿಕಕ್ಕೆ. ನನಗೆ ಖುಷಿ ಇದೆ ಹೋಗೋದು ಬೇರೆ, ಬೇರೆಯವ್ರ ಮೇಲೆ ದುಃಖ ಇಟ್ಕೊಂಡು ಹೋಗೋದು ಬೇರೆ ಅಲ್ವಾ. ಸೊ ಶಿ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟೆಡ್ ಟು ಥಿಂಕ್, ವಾಟ್ ಎವರ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಡೂಯಿಂಗ್, ಇಸ್ ಇಟ್ ರೈಟ್ ಆರ್ ರಾಂಗ್? ಶಿ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟೆಡ್ ಟು ಥಿಂಕ್. ಸೊ ದೇರ್ ವಾಸ್ ಅ ಸೀವಿಯರ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರಗಲ್ ಇನ್ ಹರ್ ಸೆಲ್ಫ್. ಅವಳು ಮತ್ತೆ ಅವಳ ಕಾನ್ಶಿಯನ್ಸ್, ಅವಳ ಆತ್ಮದ ಮಧ್ಯೆ ಏನ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಆಯ್ತು? ಸೀವಿಯರ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರಗಲ್. ನೋಡಿದಿರಲ್ವಾ ಫಿಲ್ಮಲ್ಲೆಲ್ಲ? ಸೊ ಯಾವಾಗ ಹೀರೋ ಹೀರೋಯಿನ್ಗೆ ಏನೋ ದ್ವಂದ್ವ ಬಂದಾಗ ಎಲ್ಲೋ ಒಂದ್ ಕಡೆ ಕೂತ್ಕೊಂಡಿರ್ತಾರೆ, ಅವ್ರ ಎದುರುಗಡೆ ಅವ್ರದ್ದೇ ಪ್ರತಿಬಿಂಬ ಬರ್ತದೆ, ಹೌದಾ? ಏ ನೀನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇರೋ ಸರಿನಾ, ಯೋಚನೆ ಮಾಡು, ನೀನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇರೋ ತಪ್ಪು ಅಂತ ಪ್ರತಿಬಿಂಬ ಹೇಳ್ತದೆ. ಇವ್ರು ಕೂತ್ಕೊಂಡು ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ, ಯಾಕೆ ನಾನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇರೋದು ಸರಿ, ನನ್ ವಿಚಾರ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೇನೆ ಸರಿ, ಯಾಕೆ ತಪ್ಪು ನಾನು ಅಂತ ಕೇಳ್ತದೆ. ಮತ್ ಅದು ಆ ಪ್ರತಿಬಿಂಬ ಇಲ್ಲ ನೋಡು ಹೀಗೆ ಹೀಗೆ ಅಂತ ಇಟ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೇನ್ಸ್. ಯು ಮೈಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಸೀನ್, ನೋ ಚಿಲ್ಡ್ರನ್? ಸೊ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ಸಮ್ ಟೈಮ್ಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್ಸ್, ದಟ್ ಪ್ರತಿಬಿಂಬ ಡಿಸಪಿಯರ್ಸ್. ಅದೆಲ್ಲೋ ಕಾಣೆ ಆಗ್ತದೆ, ನಿಮ್ಮ ಹೀರೋನು ಹೀರೋನು ಒಬ್ಬನೇ ಕುತ್ಕೊಂಡು ಹಿಂಗೆ ಯೋಚನೆ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ. ದೆನ್ ಹೀ ಚೂಸಸ್ ದ ಪ್ರಾಪರ್ ವೇ ಅಲ್ವಾ. ಸೊ ಹಾಗೇನೆ ಹಿಯರ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಸೀವಿಯರ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರಗಲ್ ಟುಕ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಇನ್ ವಿಜಯಲಕ್ಷ್ಮಿ ಪಂಡಿತ್ ಹರ್ ಸೆಲ್ಫ್. ದೆನ್ ಶಿ ಫೈನಲಿ ಡಿಸೈಡೆಡ್ ಟು ಕಾಲ್ ಹರ್ ಬ್ರದರ್ ಇನ್ ಲಾ, ಅಂಡ್ ಶಿ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಹಿಮ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಟೋಲ್ಡ್, ಬಿಫೋರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಅಮೇರಿಕಾ ಐ ವಾಂಟ್ ಟು ಸಿ ಯು ಅಂಡ್ family members. Then what happened? Let us see. I hadn't been with them 5 minutes before I sensed that my visit had brought a feeling of relief to everyone. I told them of my plans and asked for their good wishes before starting on this new stage of my life. The effect on me was miraculous. I felt as if a great burden had been lifted and I was free to be myself. Okay, so she went to her family members. She went to her home. There she met them and she, within 5 minutes, she felt that how happy they were. So her family members having quarrel or making this Vijayalakshmi Pandit unhappy, her family members were not there in happy because they too had loved Vijayalakshmi Pandit, no? They too felt very sad because Vijayalakshmi Pandit was sad. So when she went there, they were all relaxed. Ontara samadhana agittu avrige because they had got their loved one back to the family. So they too had felt very relaxed. And she felt that a great burden was had been lifted and I was free to be myself. ಅವಳ ಮೇಲಿರುವಂತಹ ಏನು ಗ್ರೇಟ್ ಬರ್ಡನ್ ಇತ್ತಲ್ವ, ಯಾಕೆಂದ್ರೆ ಶಿ ವಾಸ್ ಅನ್ಹ್ಯಾಪಿ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಹೂ ಶಿ ಲವ್ಡ್ ವೆರಿ ಮಚ್. ಶಿ ವಾಸ್ ಅನ್ಹ್ಯಾಪಿ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಹರ್ ಮದರ್ ಲ್ಯಾಂಡ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಅಟ್ ಲೀಸ್ಟ್ ಆ ಫ್ಯಾಮಿಲಿ ಮೆಂಬರ್ಸ್ ಜೊತೆ ಏನವಳು ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ಇತ್ತು ಅದು ಸಾಲ್ವ್ ಆದ ತಕ್ಷಣ ಶಿ ಫೆಲ್ಟ್ ವೆರಿ ಹ್ಯಾಪಿ. ಮೇ ಬಿ ದೇ ಮೈಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಗಿವನ್ ಶೇರ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಫ್ಯಾಮಿಲಿ ಪ್ರಾಪರ್ಟಿ ಟು ವಿಜಯಲಕ್ಷ್ಮಿ ಪಂಡಿತ್ ಆಸ್ ವೆಲ್ ಆಸ್ ಹರ್ ಡಾಟರ್ಸ್. ಅಂಡ್ ಯು ಶುಡ್ ನೋ ಚಿಲ್ಡ್ರನ್, ಆಫ್ಟರ್ very 9 years of the independence, in the year 1956, our Indian government passed a law which gave equal right to women in the family property. Daughters as well as wives, they will have equal right in the family property. That law gave individual existence. That law recognized the individual existence of women. So we were ruled by the British for 200 years, no? British never thought of making good to us, right? They did not think about the situation of Indian women. They were selfish. They worked for their betterment. So after getting independence, is it easy to solve all the problems? No, obviously it is not. But within a very short period, Indian law gave an individual existence. Indian law recognized the individual existence of the women. It gave equal right to women in the family property. Maybe Vijayalakshmi Pandit's contribution is also there for this decision of Indian government. Anyhow, in this way, Mahatma Gandhiji's advice. What is the advice? No one can harm you except yourself. That advice calmed down. That advice helped Vijayalakshmi Pandit to live happily in her motherland with her family members. Okay, let us complete today's lesson here. I'll add one more thing to your homework. Come to page number 10, children. Yes, here they have given three columns. In first column, they have given the list of adjectives and verbs. Then they have given the list of some suffixes there. In your previous classes, you might have learned. So by adding these suffixes to these adjectives and verbs, they have formed some new nouns. One example we will take. Here, exist they have taken. It is a verb. Then here they have got a suffix called ence. By adding ence to this exist, they have formed a new noun here called existence. Okay, so next you have same type of question here. Now you can find, you have to solve the next one. They have given a list of verbs for you in activity A there. By adding suffixes to those verbs, you have to form new nouns. So thank you very much. If you have any doubt, contact me.